Alright guys, we're back in my garage for another video. If you're new to the channel, I use these videos to help keep you updated on the latest developments in our community, as well as discuss technical topics so that we have a better understanding of how our engines work. So if you're interested in videos like that, be sure to subscribe. There will be a lot more coming out in the future. So today we're going to be talking about the new intake manifold that's coming from RK AutoWorks. They already have an intake manifold on the market, but they're going to be introducing a new competition version of their intake manifold. So in this video, we're just going to talk about what changed and why this one is coming about. So hopefully you guys can determine whether this is the right parts for your build. So all of you know that an intake manifold on our cars has two primary purposes. It has to be strong enough to hold the boost that you're running, and it has to be efficient enough to cool off your intake temps. Now, most metal manifolds address both of those. Of course, the metal is going to be stronger than the plastic. Running higher boost levels on upgraded turbos can cause the stock plastic manifold to crack or fail. So with an upgraded metal manifold, the goal is to reduce the risk of that happening. As long as you know the metal is strong and all your welds are good, you shouldn't have to worry about that. Now they also all have a bigger core than stock, and the goal here again is to reduce your intake temps. Higher boost means higher temperatures, so you need more cooling to keep your temperatures low. And especially if you're drag racing, going from a stop where you don't have a lot of airflow, you need an extremely efficient core to keep your temps as low as possible or potentially even help them go down. Unfortunately, the RK AutoWorks intake manifold didn't seem to perform well in the cooling category. I think the best case that I saw was it pretty much matched the stock manifold, which isn't the end of the world. You know, the stock manifold does a pretty good job of cooling off your intake temps while you're driving. But if you're drag racing, that can definitely be a problem because it doesn't have enough airflow to work as efficiently as you would like. So a lot of people were having temps that matched the stock manifold, but also I saw a lot of people experience temps that were worse than the stock manifold. This largely seemed to be due to issues with bleeding the circuit, especially on the Gen 1, where with the stock manifold, we have that bleeder line at the top of the manifold. That helps a lot because the manifold is the highest point in your cooling system. So having that extra line that returns air or coolant back to the reservoir just makes sure it's constantly bleeding itself while the system is running. The RK AutoWorks intake manifold doesn't have that. So it was a little bit more difficult to bleed if you weren't vacuum filling it. Eventually they did add a little bleeder screw at the back of the manifold to make it easier to get all of the air out, but it still didn't seem to perform any better than the stock one. So with this coming in, I think the goal is to produce a manifold that's not just stronger than the stock plastic one, but also cools better than the stock plastic one. Now, fortunately, they have provided some logs about this. There is still a pretty big increase in temperatures in the log that I've seen. They posted this on an MT40i, but keep in mind this MT40 was running over 40 pounds of boost. So it's a really big stress test. I think compared to most people that were running like 25 to 30 PSI, it pretty much matches the temp increase. So at lower boost levels, you should see much better IATs and potentially even a flat curve that will prevent it from getting too hot by the end of a drag run. I'll also have that log linked down in the description if you guys want to check it out for yourself. Now, as far as other features, so they have mentioned that this is going to be 100% bolt-on without any modifications to the car. So even though they're putting a bigger core in there, it's not going to require any trimming or cutting to get it to fit. It, of course, also still has port injection integrated into the manifold. So if you want to run fuel port injection, methanol, nitrous, all of that will be able to plug in directly into the manifold. It'll also have additional ports. So if you need any extra boost references for auxiliary components, you can pull it from the manifold that way. This one is also going to come with a phenolic spacer. So what that means is there's going to be a plate between the manifold and the cylinder head that prevents the heat transfer from the engine, which I think was another downside of the original manifold. Without that spacer, you're going to have heat transferring from the engine to the metal manifold, and that's going to make it less efficient. So now the manifold will be more of its own standalone component. Some engine bay heat will get into there, but it's going to be a lot less than what was being transmitted by the cylinder head previously. At launch, this is only going to be for Gen 1, but they did say that a Gen 2 one will be coming soon. I'm also not sure on pricing. I can assume that it's going to be a little bit more expensive and probably more in line with the other options on the market. I know a lot of people were going this route originally because it was pretty much the cheapest one available, but now with the bigger core and the expanded manufacturing, I think it's going to be more expensive. We'll just have to see when it's officially released. So hopefully this answers all the questions that you guys have about this manifold coming out. I definitely think it's going to be a game changer compared to the original one. As always, we'll just have to see as more people get their hands on it, how those logs look and how it performs so that we get a better feel of how it'll perform. So yeah, that's it for this video. Thank you guys for watching and I hope this helps. And if you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below. Do 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 do.